MST coming your way, and I'm in New York City with Sade, because this is a whole hour dedicated to Sade, because we're going to be chilling with her, and it's a pleasure. Pleasure to see you. All right. Now, I mean, you know, the good thing is, you know, listening to your new record, Lovers Rock, it's like the beauty of it is, it's like you haven't gone anywhere. It's like there hasn't been a missed note, a missed beat. It's just like bang, like you've fallen right into place. We're gonna talk about the new record in a second, but let's actually head back and like the early 80s, and you were with the group Pride, mm-hmm. Featuring the three cats, Stuart Matthewman, Andrew Hale, and Paul Spencer Denman. Yeah. And then you moved on and you created Sade. Did you ever think that lyrically and musically you would hit and touch so many people?
No, I mean, it was a surprise, you know. At the time, I just sort of accepted it, you know, when it was happening, and I had no choice than to accept it, because it was just going on. And then when I reflected and had time to look back, you know, I was amazed, yeah, really, at what had happened.
What was that time like for you guys as a group, you know, just doing what you did? I mean, you know, you're doing something, you think, yeah, this is cool, sounds great, looks good.
Well, I think particularly me, because, you know, I was fronting the band, you know, things changed quite a lot. But we were doing so much, and it was so relentless, the amount of stuff that we were doing, that, like I said, we didn't really know what was going on. And it was only later that we thought, you know, look what's happened and look how things have changed. But I think because we're a band, it made it easier. If it'd been me on my own, I think I may well have called it a day way back then, and yeah, you know, carried on loving music but from afar. And but because they were there, it was something that was kind of shared there, you know. And they always encouraged me and said, you know, you have to just keep on, you know, doesn't matter how much it changes around you, and people's perception of you changes, although you're the same person, suddenly the perception is that you are a different person. And but after a while, you know, I grew to be used to it, and just fortunately, you know, for me now, you know, we carried on.
The beauty of your music is the fact that you touch so many different people. Hip-hoppers are into, I mean, I can name a whole bunch of hip-hop records where Sade's definitely been getting some love. You know, you have, you know, people, you know, parents are feeling your music. How do your fans relate to you? Like, and when, you know, when they meet you, do they pour out their hearts to you and tell you?
Yeah, it's really, I do, now it sounds a bit corny, but I feel a lot of love, I really do.
Because you're giving love,
and it's so nice when you feel it, like, when you realize that it's simple, you know, it's simple. You make a record and people like it or they don't like it, and if they do and they feel something from it, they tell you. And it's really nice on that level. It's really simple and basic, and it's nice to get that back.
Yeah. I mean, even for myself, I mean, it's taken me through, I mean, there's countless times I put your music on, and it's taken me to so many different places, and done so much for me. And that must be, like I said, must be a really gratifying feeling for you to actually feel that love.
It really is. Yeah.
You know what we're gonna do? We're gonna head back, and we're gonna check out from the Diamond Life CD. We're gonna check out Smooth Operator, because we're chilling with Sade. We'll be back.